Double XL with Lokesh on City
1016. पिछले डेढ़ घंटे से मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि डैडी आने वाले हैं, डैडी आने वाले हैं, डैडी कूल इज फाइनली हियर. We'll be talking about the film Daddy that's releasing on the 7th of September here in Dubai. And of course, Arjun Rampal, who's playing many roles in Daddy, role of an actor, producer, writer, is here in the studios of City 1016. So welcome, Arjun.
Oh, thank you so much.
Along with Arjun, we also have Sunil from B4U. And welcome.
Hi, Sunil. Guys.
And of course, our team, Karishma ji and Meghna ji in the studio.
You mean our shrunken team. Because I'm sure all of us would give anything in the world to be here right now. But we're so glad that everyone else is on holiday.
No, but you've given me the warmest and the most amazing reception. As soon as I walked in, I almost fainted because it was so embarrassing.
And this is, it's extremely ironic when Arjun Rampal, who's one of the most good-looking men in the world, safe to say, surrounded by women from different nationalities, which is true to the UAE essence, turns around and says, this is really embarrassing. You're like, okay, by now you should be used to it.
No, because they all had Daddy there. I was like, what the hell is this? I had Daddy placards, like Daddy number one. Who's your daddy? I was like, oh, yeah, ye kya ho gaya?
But the ladies are really excited. So this local Emirati woman came up to me and she said, so who's coming today? And we said, it's Arjun Rampal. I know him. I know him. I have to be right in front. I know him. It was like she knows you on a personal level. But
oh, really?
I feel like all women feel that way.
By the way, there's a fan who got in touch with us. Her name is Pooja Verma. In fact,
she's here.
She says that her passwords are Arjun Rampal. Arjun Rampal 1, 2, and multiple.
Oh, really? Oh,
no. Yeah, like she's like a crazy, crazy fan of
him. Oh, I must meet her then.
Yeah, she's here to meet you.
We definitely have. So, Daddy releasing very, very soon. I mean, what's the buzz around the film? How are you?
You tell me. I don't know. I've just been moving around from city to city.
I believe you're coming
promoting.
From New York. Yeah,
I just flew in from New York yesterday. We were here and got a really, really warm reception here.
Arjun, I wanted to ask you, you know, off late there have been a lot of biopics that have come out, okay? Yeah. And I think as a nation, as an industry, we've been playing very, very safe when it comes to biopics. Like, of course, we are, you know, talking about our national heroes and...
Sure.
But there's not really much of a human side to all these heroes that we're showing, be it Azhar, be it MS Dhoni, be it even Bhag Milka Bhag. And given the current climate in India, you know, where there's not really much of a place for different kind of opinions and this almost like everyone wants to be homogeneous, you know, that's the current wave in the country. How difficult does it become for filmmakers, you know, especially you're producing the film and writing it as well, how difficult does it get for you to deal with a biopic on a gangster turned politician who is still alive?
Lokesh, your question has taken up pretty much the length of the day.
Really?
So we'll come back tomorrow.
Actually, it's a very, very smartly put and thought out question because it's true. You know, biopics can be very, very tricky to make. Reason being because you can take one point of view and just go with that. So you don't kind of see the dark side. You don't see, you know, people, you just see the good, you know, and that's kind of glorified on whatever level. And it becomes kind of a glorified
version.
Drama, you know. So I think Oshim, that's one of the reasons I got him on as even a director for this film, was because he's got a very different take on things. We were getting an opportunity to do a true story of a gangster.
Right.
Okay. I love the genre. My favorite films are like Godfather, Goodfellas, Scarface, Carlito's Way, you know. I was hoping that I can do a gangster film one day in my career. And suddenly I had an opportunity and the stamp of approval from the man himself, Arun Gawli, to say, okay, you can tell my story. To convince him that it's not going to be just your point of view, but also the point of view of maybe your enemies, the point of view of the police, what they thought about you. Yes, the point of view of your family and the people of Dagri Chol, who call you daddy. So you will get all that. But we cannot make a propaganda film here. You know, that was, I think, the most important thing. And the challenging part of it was to do it in a way where it doesn't become a documentary. And at the same time, it's entertaining, engaging. So we treated the film like a thriller. It's an investigation. You see the film, the way we researched it, through different people's point of view.